Hello friends, I am Bharati from www.learnlikeachildren.blogspot.com. Today, in series of 8th day question or passing question or important question, I have taken the theorem, the lengths of tangents drawn from an external point to a circle are equal from the unit circles in SSLC or 10th syllabus. Okay, this theorem is very easy and you can expect this question this year, because there are only two theorems on circles. From two theorems, one definitely will be there in your question paper for this year. So either this or one more theorem, which I have already made a video on that, so you can check it out. And today's theorem is also very interesting. We can make it together. So let us start the theorem. First, let us see the statement. The lengths of tangents drawn from an external point to a circle are equal. Here we have to choose two words which are very important in this statement, because by seeing those two words, we can remember the whole theorem in the exam. So if you want me to select two important words for you, those are tangents. Yes, you know it is a theorem related to tangents only. So here tangent is very important word, and one more word, external point, very important, because this theorem deals with the tangents which are drawn from an external point to a circle. Here tangents are not there on the circle, but they are drawn from an external point to the circle. Okay, after selecting these two words, what you have to do? Yes, you have to remember these two words from this statement. After remembering these two words, next we will move to the whole statement, wherein we divide the statement into two parts. The first half gives us the figure and data, and second half gives us the statement to prove. Okay, first we will select the half of the statement, that is the lengths of tangents drawn from an external point to a circle, this much. Here the lengths of tangents means we have to draw two tangents that I have already drawn here, and an external point P is also there. Okay, circle is there, tangents are there, one external point is also there. This much we have made. Remaining things you don't concentrate, because they will be coming in your construction part. Okay, for time being you just see only these many parts. Okay, now we'll write data. In data, as you know children, whatever you see in the figure, whatever you see here in the picture, that will be the data. Okay, O is a circle. Simply we'll write whatever we see here. O is a circle. Yes, PQ and PR are two tangents. Yes, before writing PQ and PR are two tangents, one more sentence we need to add here. What is that? P is a external point. You should remember P, main important point is P here, because without an external point, you cannot write or you cannot draw two tangents from an external point. Okay, now P is external point. After P is external point, you are able to draw two tangents from this external point P. Okay, now data is correct and complete. Next we'll move to prove. What we need to prove? Now we will refer second half of the statement, that is R equal. What are equal? Yes, tangents are equal. Where are tangents? PQ and PR are our tangents, and they are equal. PQ, PR are our tangents. These two tangents are equal. To prove statement is over now. Next, construction. In construction part, we have to join the remaining parts of the whole figure. What are remaining points? Here I'll show them by dotted line. OQ, OR, these lines are constructed lines. Externally we have constructed them. Okay, let us join OQ, OP and OR. This is construction. Now directly we will move to the proof. Let us prove the statement. Now in proof, let me take two triangles and those triangles are OQP, OPR. Which type of triangles are these? Okay, to see that which type of triangles they are, first let us see OQ. OQ is radius and QP is tangent. In previous theorem, already we know that when radius is there, tangent is there, both these things are perpendicular to each other. It means here at point Q, the angle is right angle, that is equal to 90 degree. It means these two triangles are right angle triangles. So let us take two right angle triangles. First right angle triangle is OPQ and second one is OPR. In these two triangles, now we have to see the sides or angles which are equal to each other. Okay, now we know that radii of a circle are all always equal. Here OQ and OR are radii, therefore they are equal. OQ equals OR. Why? Because they are radii of same circle. If you write simply radii, that is also correct. Radii of same circle. Okay, as this is side, let us show it by S. S means side. And one more thing, now we'll move to the right angle. Because if you see other side, this one QP we cannot take it as same, because that we have to prove. Yes, apart from OQ and QP, one more side is there. Okay, let us finish that side also. Here only OP is there, but do you see two OPs for the upper triangle and lower triangle? No, only one triangle, OP is there. Then how to take this OP? Let us take this OP for both the triangles. Why? Are you thinking why I am taking this OP for both the triangles? Okay, let me explain. You just imagine this is your classroom. In your classroom, here is one wall. This is your class. It means 10th student's class. This is 10th class. And this class is for 9th. Here is 9th class board. And here is 10th class board, blackboard. Okay, I mean 10th students are calling this wall as their wall. Similarly, 9th class students also call this wall as their wall. What it means? It means this wall is common to both the classes. Okay, as this wall is common to both the classes, how will you write for 9th standard? If you call this wall as AB, for 9th standard, their wall is AB. For 10th standard, their wall is AB. Similarly, in this way, here also we'll write OP equals OP, because OP is common to both the triangles. So I can call it as common side. Okay, this is also side. Let us mention it by S. Okay, now as we have taken two sides and this side we cannot take because that we have to show our proof. Okay, now let me move to angles. This angle we can say it is right angle and this angle is also right angle. We can write something about this, but remaining angles we don't know whether they are equal or what. Okay, just leave them. We take only angle Q and angle R. because they are 90 degree, because OQ is radius and QP is tangent. Okay, OQP, which is equal to ORP. These two angles are equal. Why? Because they are equal to 90 degree or right angle. They are right angled. So because of that, they are equal. As this is angle, now we have got three conditions: side, side, angle. Why I am insisting side, side, angle? Yes, your guessing is correct. By somehow I am trying to make these two triangles congruent. Oh, this is new word, right? Congruent. What is mean by congruent? C-O-N-G-R-U-E-N-T. Congruent. Congruent means if two figures or two things, they coincide with each other, we call such figures as congruent. Suppose one boy is there, he is bowing his head in front of God. Yes, but here you are seeing his only one hand, but do you know he has pressed both of his palms in front of God? It means even though he has pressed his two palms, but we are able to see only one palm. Why? Because his two palms are coinciding with each other. Oh, such cases we call them as congruent. Here his hands are congruent hands, you can say. When it comes to geometry, if two figures keep one over the other, you must be able to see only one figure. Such figures are called as congruent figures. Okay, in congruent figures, three sides of one figure should be equal to three sides of other figure. Similarly, three angles of one figure should be equal to three sides of other figure. Oh my God, it means 6 points we have to show equal. But in reality, our mathematicians suggested that no necessary to show all the 6 points. If you are able to show only 3 points, it is sufficient that you can call two figures or two geometrical elements as congruent. Okay, this is somewhat relieving matter, right? Okay, for that only I have shown only 3 points as equal. So according to this criteria, now my two triangles are congruent. How to write congruent? Okay, let me show. We will take these two triangles. Here we have put AND. Now I'll put one more sign here in between, that is OPQ triangle OPR. Here I would put congruent sign. What is that? Congruent sign. How to write congruent sign? Now put equal sign. Over the equal sign, one S is there. Okay, instead of remembering this sign like this, you just make it in a fun way. Like, this is railway track. On railway track, S is sleeping. Correct? Yeah. Okay, this is congruent. By which criteria these two triangles are congruent, that we have to show here, that we have to write here. Which is the postulate that makes these two triangles congruent? Okay, first one is side, we agree, but OP is also side, but OP is a special side. How? It is opposite to right angle. Okay, the side which is opposite to right angle is always called as hypotenuse. Because of hypotenuse, you can mention this side as H. Okay, are you confused? No, because it is the same thing. Side means this one, hypotenuse means the same thing. Only hypotenuse is special name of the side. That's it. Okay, next, OQP, it is an angle, but it is a special angle Because of that, we are writing it as right angle. So angle is right angle, side is hypotenuse. Only that much is the difference. Now in reasons, I'll write R means right angle, H means hypotenuse, S means side. You just see, right angle, hypotenuse, side. Right RHS postulate, because of RHS postulate, these two triangles are congruent. Once we show these two triangles are congruent, then you can match any side with any side, but they should be corresponding, okay? Any angle with any angle. Now, here also we have shown these two triangles are congruent. It means I can take any side. Yeah, for that I will be taking PQ equals PR. What is PQ and PR? Absolutely, they are our tangents. Yes, the statement is proved. Then what is the reason to prove this statement? Reason is CP, CT. It is not that new word. It is familiar word only, but I have written it in a very stylish way. That is CPCT. CPCT means corresponding parts of congruent triangles. Here we have two congruent triangles, and QP and RP are corresponding parts. Only that much. Now we have come to end of this theorem. PQ is equal to PR. That means tangents are equal by CPCT. In this way, we can prove the theorem. Friends, I hope you enjoyed this theorem and understood well with the help of mnemonics. And I guess you would use these mnemonics while studying this theorem. And one more thing, if you like my explanation, you just give your thumbs up, share with your friends the content of this video, and make them also learn and prepare themselves for the exam. And same time, don't forget to subscribe my channel and just click the bell icon so that I can send my notifications to you. Until then, take care. Thank you.